is that your lust consumes you and it can't be satisfied. That's like the canker in the worm eating away at your soul. And where the fire is not quenched, anyone's name who was not found written in the Lamb's Book of Life was cast into the lake of fire. All right, the bottomless pit, a place of outer darkness. Everybody has a soul. Psychologists will tell you that there's more to you than flesh.
Soul, dark matter.
Soul, dark matter. Wait. Sorry, I got a good one. Man is created in the image of God, right?
Right.
So, explain the birth defects of disabilities.
Oh, that's easy.
Oh, they were born
sin.
A sinner.
They were
sin
born a sinner.
I forgot.
Sin corrupts.
Jesus is a sinner. I forgot. They're sitting there, you know, boozing it up.
Mission of the devil is to steal, kill, and destroy. Okay, so this question over here was prove that I'm 3-1. Joyce Meyer said, why can't I have what I want, what I think, and what I feel? That's your soul. You are a spirit, you have a soul, you live in a body. If you cut off your arm, you're still not less of a man. So the real you is the spirit. Most people are going to be the rat. Okay. Everlasting destruction. You know what? When the sinner goes to hell, he doesn't say, boy, I got a raw deal. Boy, I don't deserve this. Sinners go to hell because they want to go. God has done everything he can to get them to go to heaven. They said, no, no, no. I've heard one person say that hell
is
the most.
Born is, born
hell is the best
effect.
Thing.
That God just
born
answer
born
that.
To
she gives birth to a perfect baby.
Never heard
does that mean that the baby has sin? Because you said that the baby had a defect. The mother, even though she might be Christian, so there's sin, is sick back then. So if this war creates a perfect child with no birth defects, it is pure, supposed to be the
hey, the baby will not be punished for the mother's sin.
Well, then you just said because the baby had a defect, not a punishment. He was just born. Why
does
he have to be punished?
You're asking me how do I describe
No way. No, no.
Yeah, well, you just said that we're sinful a while back.
We live in a fallen world.
I agree with this man.
We live under
the Catholic methodology of where you are born a sinner. That's the only logical explanation. I mean, I'm pretty good at mental gymnastics, but like, I ain't a contortionist.
Okay. Now we've described hell. Blazing furnace, a place of sorrows, no rest, outer darkness. Darkness so thick you can feel it. Okay. We've got one person who wants to know why she deserves help. The Bible says, she wants to know why she deserves help. The Bible says, all the children fall short of the glory of God. That means you. Are you a sinner? Can you admit that? How many lives have you been told?
That's pretty good.
Probably one. So technically, that would make you all liars. You ever taken anything that wasn't wrong? Now, you said you were a liar. You sure you're telling the truth now?
Right.
You know, you're taking it.
Sure, I could vouch.
You're basically a good person, aren't you? But when you stand before God on Judgment Day and He judges you on the Ten Commandments, will you be innocent or guilty?
What if she's not Christian?
Innocent. But you just told me you're a liar.
Love thy neighbor.
Love thy neighbor.
I know. I'm a forgiving liar.
No,
that was a
lie.
My sins
are washed. Please, Lord, forgive me.
I'm talking about you now.
I would like to see a lizard.
Wait, sir, I've got a question. Is forgiveness cyclical? Can I sin and every night come home, forgive me, Lord, for I have sinned, and go back out and keep up with the same bullshit? I mean, I am asking forgiveness. I am asking for forgiveness, God.
Yeah! No, cannot.
New Testament yet, right?
Yeah. So which is right, Luke or Matthew? We got what? Luke says that Jesus was born about 3 years ago to come to Judea. That was in 6 AD.
Hold on, I got here.
Cornelius was come to Judea.
Oh my God, yes.
This is 6 AD. Matthew proclaims that when Jesus was born, Herod was to rule it. Herod died in 4 BCE. That's a 10-year difference where Jesus was born alive and also not yet born. Also, compare the genealogies in Matthew versus Luke. They contradict each other. I know that book better than you in the original languages in which it was written. I spent 30 years following a bunch of fairy tales. I don't have time for this shit anymore.
Then why are you here?
Because these people can go on and do something useful with their lives rather than living and believing a bunch of 2,000-year-old bullshit. It's proven wrong in every single regard.
A Bible, if
he said dinosaurs in the Bible.
Yeah! Okay. Go ahead.